the issue of a superbug is its particular case of antibiotic resistance, where the organism has gained resistance to many different types of antibiotics. At Newcastle University, we're studying the relationship between water pollution, antibiotic use, and the development of drug resistance around the world. The worst case scenario is the way it was in Victorian times. As time is proceeding, we continue to use antibiotics, and the levels of resistance are actually continuing to increase. The Ganges is a particularly interesting case for study because the river itself is very clean as it's coming out of the Himalayas. The beauty of the river is actually one of the problems. Many, many people come to the river over a short period of time. And part of the tradition of going to the Ganges is bathing in the water and drinking the water. The reality is if you have 500,000 people come to an area that's about 20 to 30 kilometers worth of river stretch, and there's no real consequential waste treatment, it's going to have an effect on the water. We detected much higher levels of resistance genes, particularly multi-resistance genes, in the Upper Ganges pilgrimage sites when the pilgrims were there. So the fact that people were going there seasonally did affect the amount of resistance genes you detected in the water. And I think the most significant finding is that when we actually looked at the relative abundances of genes, did correlations with fecal organisms, basically organisms that came from the gut of mammals, in this case, because it's such a remote area, it's almost all human, we found that the abundance of genes was 20 to 60 times higher when the pilgrims were present than when they weren't. So that meant that the people who were actually resident there in this pristine area had much lower levels of these genes in their gut than the people who were visiting. Basically, we were watching the epidemic transmission of these key genes in real time. We couldn't do a lot of our work without the cooperation of groups like the group at IIT Delhi in India and in other places where we do the work. As people are gaining wealth, especially in emerging countries, they're gaining the ability to travel. So we've shown the genetic potential for acquiring the potential for multi-resistance. We're also providing guidance, though we're not the primary guide, to people within the governments of the countries that we're working in. A lot of our effort is now looking at treatment technologies and social behavioral changes that could potentially reduce the transmission of resistance via water.